Welcome back, all you wonderful Rise of Kingdoms players out there. This is Dragothian here. Today we're going to be talking about the Legendary Tavern. I wanted to give you some tips and tricks on it because, you know, it's just kind of one of those things that have been popped into the game whenever you're in the Season of Conquest KVKs, and we've gone over it a little bit when it comes to how to use it and, you know, getting the Sovereign Keys available and ready to go for and how you get those and all that. We've done a huge 2,000 key opening as well to showcase what you can actually do with it if you've got the money to put into it. But really my thing is I wanted to show you guys on this video how you should be using it depending on how much you have to put into the game money-wise, and really the smartest and most efficient way to use it and the way I'm going to be using it, because again, I do spend into the game, obviously. I spend quite a bit, but I don't go uber kraken whale mode, if you want to go ahead and say it that way. But what we're going to do is we're going to go through this. So right now you can see I've got 107 keys in the Legendary Tavern. Why is that? Because we have roughly, let's see how many days, just over a week left in the KVK, and this will be disappearing once this KVK ends. Obviously also on the actual event, it does have a 7-day timer. So 7 days and 7 hours and it's gone. Well, what happens with your Sovereign Keys, for one, and then, you know, why haven't I used them yet is, I guess, the other thing. So, if you're a low spender, the Legendary Tavern is actually amazing, because this enables you, especially in a kingdom where you've got set MGEs, or if you're in a very powerful kingdom where you just can't, or high-spending kingdom, I should say, and you just can't crack the top 15, and it takes weeks and weeks and weeks of MGEs to go through before you can summon a commander. Well, with Legendary Tavern, you can do it relatively easily and a lot less expensive than if you were to go through the MGE process as a low spender in a heavy spending or top flight kingdom, okay? So the idea here is that you want to use Legendary Tavern to unlock those MGE commanders so that you can have them, and you use your universal sculptures on them if you want to, or just to have them so you can summon the Writer of History bundle, all that good stuff. So if we go into the shop, obviously you have options to use those coins for as well, but really what you're looking for is this here, your reward choice list. And the majority of these are going to be MGE-based commanders. There's only a few that are wheel-based commanders. So you've got Attila here, he's an MGE-based commander. You've got Theodora, you've got, Leonidas, you've got Artemisia, you've got Chandragupta, you've got Zenobia, and you have Nebuchadnezzar right now, the way it currently sits. And I had all those myself on my main account except for Nebu. So I went ahead and put some coins into the Legendary Tavern and summoned myself a Nebuchadnezzar. I think for me personally, it ended up maybe costing me, I don't know, around 20 or 30,000 gems to do, which, again, compared to going hard on an MGE to unlock and getting maybe 40 legendary sculptures or 10 or 15 or whatever, way less expensive, way less time intensive. You're not competing against anybody in the Legendary Tavern. You're only competing against yourself and your own wallet. So really it's just a matter of, do you have the investment opportunity to be able to put some gems and ultimately some keys into the tavern? And assuming you reinvest those coins that you make back from the tavern back into more keys, 1 week's purchase worth of the sovereign keys in the VIP shop should do the trick to unlock pretty much whatever commander you want one time. And again, as long as you're not going in here thinking, okay, I'm going to max whatever commander I want, if you're a low spender, you're going to be in fantastic shape. Because otherwise, if you decide that you want to completely max out these commanders, that's a lot of gems, that's a lot of keys, that's a lot of daily openings, and it's going to be very, very costly to do. So you can't go in as a low, a medium, or even decent spender and expect the Legendary Tavern to max out a commander for you from start to finish. It's just not feasible. This, to me, for anybody less than somebody like a Mad Phantom, a Baba, you know, a MF, you know, those types of players that just have unlimited money. Makote is another one comes to mind that just has dumb money to put into the game, just unlimited funds that they want to invest and have fun with, then those types of players can do it. And again, when I did my 2000 key opening video for Legendary Tavern, that was from Phantom. So he's the type of person that can be able to do that kind of thing. And theoretically, if you wanted to put as much as you wanted into it, could definitely max a commander from start to finish using the Legendary Tavern. I just don't recommend it per se for anybody else besides those types of players. But again, why do you use a Legendary Tavern? Well, for me, again, I unlocked Nebu doing this method. And then again, unlock, open the Writer of History bundle, get your MGE commanders. That way you don't have to worry about competing against other bigger players that are spending more money or what have you. And that way you can go ahead and get what you need for your account. And you can use your universals to max out whatever you'd like to do. Now, what about after that? Okay, here's the next step to that question. What do you do next? Okay, so I've already gotten my Nebu. Again, we already went through the list here. I've got all of these commanders at least summoned, and most of them are maxed for my account, but maybe not necessarily for yours. You might have, again, a lot of these commanders not maxed, and you can use all of these sculptures that you're getting, and it's not that bad. For me, I have maxed what I want maxed. So, for instance, again, with Nebu, I wanted to summon him. Eventually, I'll probably max him at some point, but maybe not on this account, maybe on a different account. So, what do you do with all these extra keys? Well, don't just pump them in here, okay? So don't just pump them into the Legendary Tavern when you've got everything you need, okay? So again, if you've got all the MG, especially MGE-wise, if you've got all the MGE commanders here, you can unlock the wheel commanders on the wheel, okay? You don't need the Legendary Tavern to do that. But with the MGE commanders, it's just you're competing against people. So there's a chance that you might not be able to place high enough on the Mightiest Governor event to unlock these commanders. So the Legendary Tavern is great for that, but if you've already unlocked all of them, if you've already unlocked all the MGE commanders, I would recommend, me personally, and this is what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be saving all my keys, because next season, whenever KVK comes out, hopefully Lilith will update the commander list here, and maybe, just maybe, Pakal will be on here, or, you know, other commanders that are in MGE, obviously the wheel commanders as well will be on here, but hopefully they'll be adding, you know, Jadwiga and Pakal and things like that to the choice list for the tavern, and you can use those keys that you've already acquired from the previous KVK into the new KVK's Legendary Tavern. And I don't believe, based off of what I've seen off of the KVKs that I've been on in 307, that you lose any of those keys as far as not being able to use them on future Legendary Taverns. You definitely don't lose them because you're actually still acquiring them, but even when you're off season. But as far as actually using them, it's the same thing. It's a sovereign key. So you should be able to start stockpiling these sovereign keys to be able to use them next KVK. And again, hopefully you'll have other commanders that aren't on the list right now that will be available in, say, 2 months, whenever you're back into KVK and you're in the middle of it and you want to unlock the latest and greatest commanders. Just saying, that's the way I'm going to do it. I know me personally, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to stockpile as many of these as I possibly can so that I can go ahead and hop right into the fray whenever we get Legendary Tavern the day before level 4 passes open in each KVK and get whatever commander I need. And I'm going to stockpile universal sculptures so that if there is a commander in there that I absolutely have to have and want, and I don't have them yet, I'm going to grab them and I'm going to max them, and we're going to have them ready for day 1 level 4 passes opening on the next KVK. So to me, that's the recommended way for almost everybody in this game. Almost everybody. I can't speak to how much you spend into the game, but everybody from a low spender all the way up to a decently high spender, the Legendary Tavern is not for you when it comes to just maxing a commander from start to finish. That's just not what it is. That's not the event that this is for you. It's to unlock the commanders, get some extra sculptures. Say you're 30 sculptures away from maxing a commander. Definitely, you can try your luck at that. But again, you saw how many commanders are in this this loot table. That's 14 commanders that are in this loot table just for the reward choice chest. This is not including all the actual commanders that are available inside the actual chest that you're opening. You're getting the season 1 stuff, you're getting season 2 stuff, you're getting season 3 stuff, so you've got all of it available, and you're not going to necessarily have a great chance to get maybe that 30 sculptures for Nebu that you need, or again, if you need 40 sculptures of YSS or Zenobia or something to max out your garrison commanders, it's going to be hard. You can do it, and it's not too bad, but it's probably better to invest in maybe a couple Kerouacs, get your universals, and you're done. That's my recommendation, guys. So I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope it's been helpful. That's just my thoughts on it. I think that this is probably the smarter way to do it. You don't have to use your keys before KBK ends. You can save them until next time. And hopefully Lilith and the developers will go ahead and pop some more of the commanders into the loot table for the reward choice list, so you can summon yourself a commander that you don't have. Hope you've enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers. Have a good one and take care.